Good morning to everyone. Today we are continuing the chapter arithmetic progression. Whatever we learned earlier, let me give some introduction of it. Arithmetic progression is the type of progression in which each of the term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term. Last time we have discussed, and you have one more example I will take. Suppose we are taking an expression 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. This is arithmetic progression because each of the terms, except the first one, all other terms 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 12, 13, 15, 17. All these can be obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term. Now the preceding term is 1. If you adding 1 and 2, 1 plus 2 is 3. Same way when you are adding 2 to this 3, we are getting 5. 5 plus 2 is 7. 7 plus 2 is 9. That way, each of the terms can be obtained when you are adding a fixed number to the preceding term. Then it is said to be AP, arithmetic progression. We have learned it in last class. Anyhow, we are just revising it. To find out whether it is an AP or not, you will find out the difference of 2 points in the term. Get the difference of 3 and 1 is 2. 5 and 3 is even 2. 7 and 5 is 2. 9 and 7 is 2. Everywhere we are getting the difference of 2. Difference of 2 consecutive terms of this sequence, this progression, we are getting as 2. Therefore, the terms of this progression are in AP. Therefore, to make sure whether the terms are in AP or not, you have to find out the difference of consecutive terms. P minus 1. From the second term, we are subtracting first term, we are getting 2. 5 minus 3, that is also 2. 7 minus 5, that is also 2. 9 minus 7, that is also 2. Everywhere we are getting the difference are same. Therefore, the sequence is in AP. And this common difference is known as this difference which are getting common in all. That is known as common difference. And we used to represent it as letter D, small d. Last day we have discussed this, as well as we have derived one formula for nth term of an AP. The formula for nth term of an AP is A plus N minus 1 into B. This is the formula for nth term of an AP. A n equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Those who have missed the last class, they can copy the formula, because this is the formula for finding the nth term of an AP. Now the AP which I have taken 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. If you want to find out the next term after 9, we have to add the common difference. Here the common difference we are getting as 2. First term, A we are getting as 1. And common difference we are getting 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. That is known as common difference. How to find out common difference? From the second term, subtract the first term. 3 minus 1. That is 2. That's the common difference. If we want to find out the 20th term of the same thing, number of terms we are considering as 2. And you want to find out what is the value of 20th term of this AP. Then, in place of n, we will put as 2 and a, we are going to put as 1 to find out the 20th term of this AP, which is increasing. Now, if you want to find out the 20th term, a 20 means 20th term. It's not a multiplication of a with 20. This is 20th term of an arithmetic progression. A20 means 20th term of arithmetic progression. The first term is 1 and the common difference is 3. Put the values. Value of A we got as 1 plus, since we want to find out the 20th term, we will put 20 here, minus 1 into D, and D we are getting as 2. That is 1 plus 19 into 2. term of this AP will be 39. Already we have discussed it. One of the examples I have shown once again, so that the revision of AN can be done in this way. A20 is 39. In the same way, we can find out any number of terms. If you want to find out 15 terms, if you want to find out 10 terms, if you want to find out 15, use the same formula. Just replace the value of 10 by the proper value. If it is 20 term, we are writing 20. If it is 10, then we are going to write 10. If you want to find out 9 term, put the value of n as 9 and accordingly. Change that accordingly and you will get the value of that term. This is 10th term of an AP. Earlier we have also done check whether the expression is an AP or not. We have to find out the difference of consecutive term. If the difference is exactly the same, then we used to say the sequence is an AP. Now we do selected questions from the textbook exercise. The formula is same. We have learned only one formula this term, that is An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. I'm giving the question, if the numbers x minus 2, 4x minus 1, and 5x plus 2 are consecutive terms of an AP. AP means arithmetic progression, where it is gradually increasing by the same amount everywhere. Find the value of x. Find the value of x. To find out the value of x, the sequence is given in AP. And if the sequence is given in AP, we know that the difference of consecutive terms will be same. The common difference will be same. The difference of second term and first term will be same as difference of third term and second term. Since sequence is in AP, so common difference of the sequence will be same. What do you mean by common difference of the sequence? Difference of second and first term will be same as difference of third and second term. First, find out third term, subtract the second term from it. That will be same as the difference of this as well as this. I've taken the example 1, 3, 5, 7 earlier. This was an AP because whatever the difference we got here, that is plus 2, you also get the difference as plus 2, you also got the difference as plus 2. Each of the number is obtained by adding the common difference to the preceding term. Therefore, they were in AP. The same way, this term given in AP. If they are given in AP, then common difference will be everywhere same. It's not necessary to get 2 only, it can be 3, it can be 1, 2, 1, 3, anything like that. Now we find out the difference of second term and first term. Second term is 4x minus 1. And from this 4x minus 1, we subtract this one. First term, x minus 2. Equal to. Third term is 5x plus 2. Second term is 4x minus 2. 5x plus 2 minus 4x minus 1. Put 4x minus 1 in bracket. Because afterwards we are going to change the sign. When you open the bracket, this will be 4x minus 1. Minus x R to become plus 2 equal to 5x plus 2 minus 4x minus 2 minus 6 plus 1. Simplify it. Take the like terms on the same side and find out the value of x. I don't have much space over here. If I'm writing, this is went up. I'm rubbing it, expecting that you understood the previous part. I'm not using it now. I'm rubbing it. And we will continue. The like terms are here 4x and x. 4x minus x equal as 3x. 2 minus 1 is plus 1. 5x minus 4x is 1x. 2 plus 1 is 3 plus 2. Further, we simplify like terms we bring together on the same side. Plus 1 here, we will bring over here. 1 we will bring over here. That is the same x. Minus x equal to 3 minus 1. 2x equal to 2 or x equal to 1. That's the answer. That's the value of x. Therefore, if you put the value of x as 1, the sequence will be AP. The terms which you got, they will be AP. Expecting that you understood. Now we will continue with some more questions. The next question is, find the 10th term of the AP. I'm moving it. 10th term of the AP. Find 10th term of AP. And the AP is 1, 4, 7, 10. 1, 4, 7, 10. Procedure is same. 10th term we have to find out. That means an. First term of this AP is 1. First term of the AP is 1. B is common difference. Since already it is given in AP, we don't have to check whether it is in AP or not. We directly consider it is in AP. We find out the difference of consecutive term. If you want, you can find out the difference of third and second, fourth and fifth term. Any difference you can find out. If you want, you can subtract 10 and 7. If you want, subtract 7 and 4. But very often, we used to subtract the first one from the second. This is not a rule, but try to make it a habit of it. Because even if you are solving the question, the examiner expects that you are subtracting the second term from the first term. 4 minus 1. Minus 3. Is expected to find out the difference of second as well as the first term. 4 minus 1, we got 3. Number of terms of which the value has to be calculated is 10. Therefore, value of 10 will be written as 10. 3 of the things we got, and our aim is to find out an. An is a plus n minus 1 b. The formula of an. Substitute each of these values. A 10 equal to, since we want to find out the 10th term of the same AP, we put value as 10. Value of a is 1 plus 10 is 10 minus 1 into d, and d we have to ask. That is 1 plus 9 into 3, 1 plus 27, that is 28. 28 is the answer. That is the 10th term of the same. Do the proper calculation. Some children used to add first and then they multiply. But according to both of us, the multiplication has to be done first and addition has to be done later on. 2 are 1 and 9 first. First multiply 9 and 3, we are getting 27. Add this 27 with 1, we got 28. This is the 10th term of this AP. Clear? Next question you write, is minus 150 a term of the given AP? I'm doing some selected questions from the first exercise, first two exercises is minus 1 term of the Riemann AP. Riemann AP is 11852 and so on. 11852 and so on. The AP which I have taken earlier, 1, 4, 7, 10. This is the previous question I am giving. This is the first term, this is second term, this is third term, and so on. We are not giving the value 6 in between. 6 will not be the term of this AP. It is not coming in this AP. After 1, we got 4, 6 is not coming, that way 7 is coming. Same way, this, in this question also, our AP is given here for our minus 150 in this way. Will it come in this AP or it will be away from it? It will not come in this AP. That's the question. To find out whether it is a term of an AP, we first consider let minus 150 is nth term of this AP, and after that, we try to find out the value of it. We know that n cannot be in fraction, n cannot be in negative. Number of terms cannot be in fraction. We cannot say 2.5 term. It will be either 1, 2, or 3. 1, 4, 7, 10, if we have taken the terms of the same. Second term, this is the third term. We haven't got 2.5 term. Number of terms cannot be in fraction. That's the main thing, get it in your mind. But minus 150 is nth term of this AP, whose first term is 11. 11. Common difference is 8 minus 11. That's minus 8. We have considered A as 11. We have considered the common difference D as difference of two consecutive terms, that is 8 minus 11, we got minus 8. We are considering this A and A as minus 50. Minus 50 we have considered nth term of the same. Formula for A and S, A plus N minus 1 into D. What the value of A? A and S minus 150. A is 11. N is not given. And D is given as minus 3. Minus 150 equal to 11. When you multiply minus 3 with 10, it is minus 3n plus 3. We simplify it. We try to find out the value of n by keeping n at one of the corner, the other values we transpose on other side. We are transposing this 11 this side as well as 3 that side. That is 3 minus 150 minus 11. Minus 3 equal to minus 3n. 11 and 3 we have brought on next side, and the value which is having n we have kept aside. On right hand side we kept. Since all these values are having negative sign, they can be added. And we are getting 164 equal to minus 3n. Value of minus 3n we got minus 64. Or n will be equal to minus 164 upon minus 3. Minus and minus cancel. This 54 to 1. We are getting 54 to 1. The value of n, we know that will never come in fraction. But in this case, we are getting the value of n is coming in fraction. So minus 150 is what you write, which is coming in fraction, which is coming in fraction. So minus 150 is not the term of given. You got the AP? Whose n term is considered as minus 150. we are trying to find out the value of x, which is coming in fraction. And we know that if the value is coming in fraction, it will not be the term of the AP. Expecting the question is understood by you. One or two questions will do today. Now for that, we will do the continuation of it next time. You also practice the question of your own. So many questions are given. All those questions has to be practiced yourself. During this lockdown, teachers can only help you. You have to practice it on your own. The sequence, which is an AP. Next question is that which term of AP? This is exercise 3.2, question number 4. Question number 4. Which term of the AP? 3, 8, 13, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. We got here the sequence. Suppose the first term is 3. Common difference will clarify out later. One of the term of this AP is 78. We will find out which term of this sequence is 78. Already given in AP, therefore we don't have to check whether it is an AP or not. We will put all these values in this formula. Formula we have to have here the one formula. We try to put in this formula. Here is first term we want as 3. First term is 3. First term is A and A is considered as 3. The common difference is difference of constant term, the difference of A and 3 is 5. Now what is the 78 given? 78 is actually one of the term of this AP. That is 3, 8, 13, one of the term will be 78. If one of the term is 78, this is not actually n. N we have to find out. Then what is the 78?
An.
Value of the n term is 78. The term which is coming, suppose you got, this boy got the 10 marks in class 1. This is first class. Second class he got 20 marks. He has improved around this level he got. Third class he got 30. In that way, if the question is in which class he got 100 marks, if we continue in this way, which class he got 100 marks? This is the value of the nth term. We will get this as 10th class. In 10th class, child has got 100 marks. And the value which he got, that is 100. 10, 20, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30. That way the 100 will come in this AP. And the value of n in which class he got 100, that is the value. Value now, the value is given 78 for n. A is 3. That is not given. And B is given as 5. 78 equal to 3 plus 5 and minus 5. Because 5 has been multiplied to 4. Bring the like terms on the same side which are having n has to be kept aside and all the values have to be taken on one side. That is 78 minus 3 minus 5 we are bringing this side and then plus 5 equal to 5n. 78 plus 5 is 83. 83 minus 3 is 80. 80 equal to 5n. Or n equal to 80 upon 5, that is 16. Make sure that the value of n you should not get in fraction. You should not get in negative because the number of terms cannot be negative. It cannot be in fraction. Here we are getting n as 16. It's not coming in fraction, which is not coming in even negative. Therefore, this is the final answer. We got therefore 16th term of the sequence or AP will be 78. Tomorrow we will continue with the chapter. Certain other questions I will show. And if you are having any doubt, you can raise your hand. I put the recording off, therefore your words and nothing will be recorded. If you are having difficulty, 5 minutes, I'm giving that to you. These questions, if you are having any doubt, you can ask. Do you have any difficulty? Just raise your hand so that I can answer you.